Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and have the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 3rd of May. Congress ends suspense, announces Rahul Gandhi to contest from Raebareli. Water shortage upsets residents of Pakistan's Karachi. And Rohingya refugees suffer brutal heat wave in Bangladesh camp. And now for all the details. After days of speculation, India's main opposition Congress party on Friday announced that Rahul Gandhi will contest general elections from the bastion seat of Raebareli. Meanwhile, his sister Priyanka Gandhi has refused to come under pressure to fight the polls. Congress chose KL Sharma to fight from Amethi, which Rahul lost to BJP's Smriti Irani by around 55,000 votes in 2019. Instead, Rahul Gandhi chose to fight from Raebareli, which Sonia Gandhi has been representing since 2004. The adjoining seats of Raebareli and Amethi have been strongholds of the family for decades, as they have elected generations of Gandhis or their close relatives since the 1950s. However, the party itself has sunk to historical lows since it was swept out of power by Modi in 2014 and has been struggling to revive itself.
खरगे जी का, सोनिया जी का, राहुल जी का, प्रियंका जी का से हृदय से धन्यवाद देता हूँ कि उन्होंने मेरे जैसे छोटे कार्यकर्ता को इतनी बड़ी जो उनकी पारिवारिक सीट है उसकी जिम्मेवारी मेरे को दिया है। मैं पूरी कोशिश करूँगा कि यहाँ मेहनत करूँ। मैं यहाँ 40 साल से इस क्षेत्र की सेवा कर रहा हूँ। 1983 में यहाँ आया था, एज ए यूथ कांग्रेस की तरफ से मेरी ड्यूटी लगी थी वहाँ पर, तो उसके बाद से मैं कंटिन्यू यहाँ पे कर रहा हूँ। मैं राजीव जी के साथ अपना कैरियर शुरू किया था 1983 में। राजीव जी मेरे को लेके आए थे यहाँ पे, तो उसके बाद फिर ऐसे हालात बनते गए कि मैं यहीं का यहीं रह गया।
Meanwhile, PM Modi took a jibe at the opposition party, saying he had earlier predicted that the Gandhi sign would run away and look for a safe seat after polling in Wayanad is over. The Prime Minister also criticized Sonia Gandhi for taking the Rajya Sabha route to enter Parliament and not contesting Lok Sabha elections.
Parliament mein kaha tha, tab to chunav ko 2 mahine ki, 3 mahine ki der thi. Maine kaha tha. इनकी सबसे बड़ी नेता चुनाव लड़ने की हिम्मत नहीं करेगी, वो डर के मारे भाग जाएगी और वो भाग करके राजस्थान गई और राजस्थान से राज्यसभा में आई और हुआ भी यही। मैंने पहले ही बता दिया था कि शाहजादे वायनाड में हारने वाले हैं और हार के डर से जैसे ही वायनाड में मतदान समाप्त होगा वो दूसरी सीट खोजने लग जाएंगे और अब दूसरी सीट पर भी उनके सारे चेले चपाटे कह रहे थे अमेठी आएंगे, अमेठी आएंगे, लेकिन अमेठी से भी इतना डर गए, इतने डर गए, वहां से भागकर अब रायबरेली में खोज रहे हैं रास्ता। ये लोग घूम घूम कर सबको कहते हैं डरो मत। मैं भी आज उन्हें कहता हूं और बड़े जी भर के कहता हूं, अरे डरो मत, भागो मत।
Amid reports of Chinese activities near the Siachen Glacier, India on Thursday said it has registered a protest with China over illegal attempts to alter facts at the Sakshgam Valley. Responding to a query during the weekly press briefing, Foreign Ministry spokesperson Randhir Jaiswal reiterated India's stand of rejecting the China-Pakistan boundary agreement and added that Sakshgam Valley is part of the territory of India. He added New Delhi reserves the right to take necessary measures to safeguard its interests. In past few months, Beijing has ramped up military infrastructure and roads in the Sakshgam Valley, a trans-Karakoram tract ceded by Islamabad under the terms of the 1963 boundary agreement. Construction of such infrastructure in the region in the medium term could pose a military threat to Indian forces stationed in Ladakh, reports have suggested.
सक्षमवादी की जहां तक बात है, ये हमारा अपना, हम इसको अपना टेरिटरी मानते हैं, अपना क्षेत्र मानते हैं. हमने कभी ये स्वीकार नहीं किया है जो सो कॉल्ड तथाकथित पाकिस्तान चीन बाउंड्री जो अग्रीमेंट है 1963 का, उसको हम लोगों ने कभी नहीं माना है. जिसके जरिए, जिसको होकर, जिसके जरिए पाकिस्तान ने ये जो जमीन है, वहां की जो क्षेत्र है, उसको चीन के अधीन किया था. एंड और हमने हमेशा इसका खंडन किया है. हमने अपना विरोध भी जारी किया है चीनी सरकार के साथ, चीनी साइड के साथ, कि आप जो जमीनी हकीकत है उसको बदलने की कोशिश ना करें. और हम हमेशा, वी हैव द राइट टू रिजर्व, वी फर्दर रिजर्व द राइट टू टेक नेसेसरी मेजर्स. जो हमारा अपना मूल, जो हमारी इंटरेस्ट है, उसको हम सेफगार्ड करने की हर कोशिश करेंगे.
Meanwhile, in a sharp retort, India responded to Pakistan by stating that Islamabad harbors a most dubious track record in all aspects, slamming the destructive and pernicious remarks made by Pakistan's permanent representative to the United Nations on Thursday. Senior diplomat Ruchira Kambod stated that India endeavors to cultivate a culture of peace amid these challenging times, and its focus remains steadfast on constructive dialogue. We thus choose to set aside the remarks from a certain delegation, which not only lack decorum but also detract from our collective efforts due to their destructive and pernicious nature, she added. The remarks from Kamboj came after Pakistan's envoy to UN, Munir Akram, in his address to the General Assembly, brought up Kashmir and made references to the CEA and the Ram Temple in Ayodhya. Reiterating Pakistan's Foreign Office statement, Akram also accused New Delhi of targeted killings in Pakistan. Earlier on Thursday, Pakistan Army Chief General Asim Munir also brought up the Kashmir issue, calling India the arch rival of Pakistan. Claimed by both New Delhi and Islamabad, India and Pakistan have fought multiple wars over Kashmir region. New Delhi maintains that the territory of Jammu and Kashmir is an integral part of India and Islamabad has no locus standi on it. Amid rising population and climate change, the issue of water shortage is worrying residents in Pakistan's Karachi. They blame a failed supply system and government negligence has led to the water crisis. A report.
Locals in Pakistan's Karachi city have been facing a massive water crisis, increasing severity with every passing day due to a failing distribution and supply system. With millions of inhabitants, Karachi is the largest city in Pakistan, but locals have long blamed its water distribution system is dysfunctional due to the government negligence. Water is only distributed through pipelines in half of the city.
कदीमी पुराने लेने लगे हुए, अभी हम जितने भी इसमें खुदाई करेंगे, सेवरेज के लेन डालेंगे, मगर उस पानी के लेन को नहीं छेड़ेंगे, क्योंकि इसको छेड़ने वाला कोई पैदा भी नहीं हुआ. हम चेयरमैनों के पास जाते हैं, वो कहते हैं हम इसका मसला हल करेंगे, आपको पानी मिलेगा. जब हम घर में जब मोटर चलाते हैं ना, तब उसमें बदबूदार पानी आते हैं, उससे आजकल बच्चों को मोशन है, दस्त हो रहे हैं. इसके सबसे बड़ा वजह था, अस्पतालों में जाओ, आज अस्पतालों में बच्चों के लिए जगह ही नहीं है.
This shortage has also led to the creation of water mafias which run hundreds of illegal pumping stations, while the megalopolis faces absolute water stress.
Na bijli mil rahi hai, na gas mil raha hai, na pani mil raha hai. Aise samajh mein hum jaye to jaye, ye Pakistan chhod ke chale jaye kya? Jo nayi nasal hamari paida hui hai, wo kahan jayegi? Kis jagah jaake apne aap ko jo hai na settle kare? Kahan jaake kaun si cheeze mil rahi hai pehle ye bata. Aur tanker mafia sabse main cheez jo hai, वाटर बोर्ड जो है, वो टैंकर माफिया जो बना हुआ है, वो लोगों को सेवा पानी दे ही नहीं सकता, वो क्योंकि टैंकरों को पानी मिल रहा है, पैसा करोड़ों रुपया खा रहे हैं, आई समझ में अरबों रुपया उनकी जेबों में जा रहा है.
Following a meeting between Afghanistan, Kazakhstan and Turkmenistan, the Taliban administration has agreed to build a logistics hub in western Afghanistan aimed at making the Wharton nation a major logistics point for regional exports, including oil from Russia to South Asia. The country's acting commerce minister in an interview said that technical teams would draw up a written agreement within 2 months on the formal plans for the hub, which all three countries would invest in after 6 months of talks. As foreign aid to Afghanistan falls and the predominantly agricultural economy is marred by persistent drought, the Taliban has faced questions over how to fund development and avoid economic stagnation. The new hub was part of broader efforts to take advantage of Afghanistan's strategic location, which lies between South and Central Asia and also shares borders with China.
توافق مذاکرات سه جانبه کار کردیم و الحمدلله دمی روزایی که گذشت ما موافق به این شدیم که هم طرف قزاقستان، ترکمنستان و افغانستان یک پروگرام یک کنفرانس سه جانبه داشته باشه. دیروز اگرچه روز جمعه هم بود، بازم نظر به ما برنامه‌ای که قبل سنجش شده بود الحمدلله ما نشست ما را برپا کردیم و در عموم موضوعات و مسائل الحمدلله بسیار با همی و بسیار به اخلاص و به خلوص نیت پیش رفت.
Over a million Rohingya living in the Kuttupalong refugee camp in Bangladesh are suffering a brutal heat wave with temperatures reaching up to 42 degrees Celsius. Kuttupalong is one of the largest refugee settlements in the world, and even though authorities have encouraged people to stay indoors during the day, many are forced to go about their daily activities, exposing themselves to extreme temperatures. People in Kuttupalong collect rations, cook and strip bamboo for building materials daily. The heat in informal structures is unbearable, driving them outdoors to seek shelter under trees or umbrellas.
বেশি গরম গরম পড়িলে এডে গাছগুলা নাই তেল ফালর বাসা তো মানুষ গরম বেশি পড়ে মানুষ ঘন থাকি না পারে নিচে বাসা তেল ফালর বাসা.
There have been reports of heat strokes and severe dehydration. Left exposed to the elements, several children have developed skin conditions. Over the past 30 days, Bangladesh has recorded extreme temperatures every day. Scientists have said climate change is contributing to more frequent and severe heat waves during summer months. And in a bid to raise voter awareness, India's Election Commission this week launched a hot air balloon in southern Belgaum as a reminder for voters to exercise their right to vote. The activity was especially targeted at youth voters to capture their attention and boost voter turnout. The poll panel and political parties have been worried about voter turnout due to the summer heat and wedding season in some parts of the country, while turnout falling to around 65% in the first phase from nearly 70% in 2019. Meanwhile, students in Western Gujarat applied henna on each other's hands, writing slogans on voting awareness. This seven-phased polling in India began on April 19 and will go on till 1st of June. Results are expected on 4th of June.
जहाँ पर लो वुमन बॉर्डर एरिया हम जिसको आइडेंटिफाई करके हमने रिकॉग्नाइज किया है, वहाँ पर बच्चों ने लेडीज़ के हाथों में मेहंदी रखी और उनको वहाँ एक रिमाइंडर दिया है. जैसे हम मोबाइल में रिमाइंडर सेट करते हैं, वैसे उनके हाथ पर मेहंदी के जरिए एक रिमाइंडर दिया गया है कि 7th मई को उनको इंडीड वोटिंग के लिए जाना है.
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.